Whether you're editing a YouTube video, a short film, or even a TikTok, adding sound effects can quickly transform your videos from good to great. However, if you don't add them tastefully or mix them correctly, you'll take the viewer out of your video quicker than you can say Storyblocks. Speaking of Storyblocks, if you're looking for royalty-free sound effects, our library has over 42,000 professionally recorded options to choose from. From weather and horror to alarms and explosions, you'll find everything you need to bring your projects to life. Learn more by clicking the link down below. The first step when adding sound effects is getting them into your project. You'll want to organize everything into a dedicated sound effects folder and potentially add more layers of organization depending on how large your project is. When importing, simply drag and drop the audio files into the projects window or the specific bin within your project. If you have a Storyblocks subscription, you can stay in Premiere using our plugin for Adobe Creative Cloud. Before adding anything from the plugin, I like to make sure that my local sound effects folder is selected as the destination. To do this, click the profile icon within the plugin and then download settings. Browse to select the correct folder, then click confirm. Now, anything you download from within the plugin will be added locally to this folder. When downloading from the plugin, make sure you're highlighting the bin you'd like the files added into within Premiere. If you're downloading several different sound effect types, you can highlight different bins for each category. With the media in your project, you can now begin to layer sound effects. First, watch through and add any sound seen on screen, or diegetic sound. With the first layer added, rewatch and add sound effects for moments not seen on screen. This could be something like a branch rustling or birds chirping. These environmental sounds really help to immerse the viewer. With diegetic and environmental elements added, take another pass and add risers, hits, and stingers to build or release tension. Once you position the sounds where they work in your timeline, it's time to really bake them into your story. And you can do that with audio effects. Just look in the effects window, then navigate to the audio effects or audio transitions folders. I recommend fading in sound effects to avoid the harsh pop that you can sometimes hear when you don't have a fade in. To do that, you can add the constant power effect onto your sounds by navigating to effects, audio transitions, crossfade, or with Shift plus D while selecting the audio clip. Additionally, you can use the essential sound panel to tag your sound effects. Once you do that, you'll be able to choose from different presets for specific kinds of sound effects. After you've added effects, you'll want to balance out your audio levels. It's best to keep all levels peaking between negative 24 and negative 8 decibels. For sound effects, make sure they sit somewhere between negative 10 and negative 20 decibels. Go higher and you risk distorting your audio. To get the balance just right, I'd recommend investing in a good set of headphones. They'll help you catch the subtle differences in volume and ensure your mix is spot on. Finally, watch through the entire video and keep an eye on your audio levels to make sure they're consistent. The last thing you want is for a viewer to be constantly turning their volume up or down on their speakers because it's too loud or too quiet in different sections of your video. And there you have it. You've successfully added sound effects to your Premiere Pro project. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And head over to storyblocks.com for unlimited downloads of royalty-free 4K footage, templates, music, and more.